As we just saw, we're limited in what we can represent in tabular data. In many situations, we have data items with fields that have subfields. As programmers, we're accustomed to this way of thinking. We have objects that have fields that reference other objects, and a lot of times, all the objects have several fields of their own. So here we're looking at the Beatles discography page on Wikipedia. This is the page we use to produce that data that we looked at earlier. Okay, so if we were to represent this data in a tabular form, in a CSV file or Excel worksheet, we need to do some unwinding. Given that we've got certifying authorities here and different types of certifications, gold record, platinum record, and so on, there's also this additional complicating factor that an individual record can be certified as some multiple platinum. So this particular album is a multi-platinum record, 4x platinum. Platinum means it sold 1 million copies. 4x platinum means it sold more than 4 million copies. So if we wanted to represent this part of this data set in a tabular form, we would essentially need two columns for every certifying authority. One for what level of certification, and one for the multiplier. Aside from being tedious and error-prone, this is just a really unnatural way to represent this data. So this is why the JSON standard has emerged for modeling data and as a means of transmitting data between systems. So let's take a look at a way of representing this data in JSON. I'm just going to look at A Hard Day's Night. Hard Day's Night is interesting because it was actually released on two different labels on two different dates. So let's take a look then at how we might do this in JSON. All right, so what I've done is I've taken just the Hard Day's Night data and implemented it as a JSON object. Okay, so you can see that we have a field for title, artist, and releases. And as we scroll down through this data, you can see that releases is actually an array. Okay, in this case, I've got two because if you remember, we have two different releases for this, one on the United Artists label and one on the Parlophone label. Okay, what we've done here as well, because the chart positions are in reference to a specific release, we need to make them part of the appropriate release object within the releases array. So in this case, the peak chart position for the United Artists release of A Hard Day's Night in France was 5, in the UK was 1. We also need to associate the certifications with the release because a different release will have different certifications. So here we've got the different certifying authorities, and then for that RIAA certification, it has the multiplier of 4 because it was actually a 4x platinum album. Okay, and here is the release data for the other release, the one on Parlophone. So this is a way of representing the data in JSON. And it's important to note that JSON objects are just like dictionaries in Python and many other languages. There's a data type in most programming languages that's analogous to a JSON object. In Python, it happens to be a dictionary. Many other languages have dictionary or map-like data types that are very similar to JSON object. And most programming languages have arrays as well. In Python, they happen to be called lists. Okay, so let's just document some of what we have to remember about JSON here.